When I started to learn to code, I was lost. I did not know where to start. I did not know how to find good resources. I did not know how to structure my time to learn as much as possible. It's been more than 11 years since, and today I know a thing or two about that. So in this video, I'm going to share you how I hacked my brain to learn to code and how you too can use these tips to become a better developer. And today I'm going to show you 4 tips of how you can hack your brain to code better and learn to code better, and make sure that you stay tuned till the end because there's an extra juicy bonus there that I accumulated over the 11 years that I've been learning to code and teaching code. So yeah, make sure that you stay till the end. Now, all of this is in the perspective of SWIFTUI Camp. Now, SWIFTUI Camp, you can take a look at the link in the description for a 50% off. SWIFTUI Camp is where you can master SWIFTUI. You can learn how to build out a production-ready SWIFTUI apps, and all of these tips are inside the camp. So I'm using all of these. So let's start by number one, is that you want to nail the fundamentals. Of course, this is a no-brainer, but many courses kind of skip over the fundamentals. They assume you already know some stuff. No, not in SWIFTUI Camp. At the very beginning of our tutoring sessions, we are going to learn about views, horizontal stacks, text, all of that, layout, data handling, all of that stuff that are considered the fundamentals of SWIFTUI. And of course, you need to learn the fundamentals because that's where you are going to build upon. You are going to advance from that. So in any discipline, you have to nail the fundamentals. Okay, my number two tip is to learn by utility. So utility-based learning is what I did over these 11 years. What that means is whenever I have a problem, or I want to build an app, or I have some sort of an issue, I learn that and only that. So for example, if I wanted to build out apps in iOS better and faster and smarter, then I turn from UIKit to SWIFTUI. So I learn SWIFTUI. Or if I wanted to implement, I don't know, a video recorder into my application, I needed to learn AV Foundation. So whatever came up to me, I just learned that. That is utility-based learning, and this is what we are going to learn also in SWIFTUI Camp, because we are going to build out a Twitter clone application with Firebase, the Firestore database authentication and storage. So as problems occur, or we need to come up with solutions for certain criteria of our application, we are going to solve that, and you are going to see me solving that. So yeah, that's a really good part of SWIFTUI Camp, that we have a problem and then we come up with a solution for that. And that is basically utility-based learning. You don't have to know everything about everything. You have to just know what you are building and how you can search for that and have a solution inside your code for that. Now, tip number three is kind of a counterintuitive one, and that is it's a long one, so why don't we just read this out loud. Active recall and spaced actionable repetition by application. Now, I know this is a mouthful, but I'm going to go through it one by one. Active recall. Now, what that means is that let's say you are going through a tutorial like you do in SWIFTUI Camp. I'm just going to teach you 1.5 hours, and then you are going to get the recording and you are going to take a look at it. Now, after you take a look at it, you are going to wait a little bit. After you have watched the recording, then you should actively recall it. Like, you should, and I advise this in SWIFTUI Camp, you should start your own project. That means that you are going to create your own project, follow along the tutorial, and then after a few days, this is what I recommend, you start building it out on your own. Maybe you're going to take a look at the recording for, some clearance and all of that. Maybe there's, a function or a view modifier that you don't really recall. But you should use active recall. You are going to build out that solution to our problem by actively recalling and not just copying and pasting from a tutorial, from my recording. Now, this is spaced repetition. You want to wait a little bit. You want to wait a few days. That's why all of these sessions are on a weekly basis. So one session per week. So you have time for this tip. So you wait a few days and then you implement what you have learned the previous days. Okay, now this is an actionable repetition because you want to take action. It's not like stuck in tutorial hell. You just sit there and just consume the tutorials. You want to make it actionable. That's how you learn stuff. And also actionable repetition by application. This is kind of the last part of this tip. You want to build. Even if it's not the same project, you want to build with the knowledge that you gained across these actively called space repetition. Okay, I know that was a mouthful, but this is really, really effective technique to learn to code. Okay, and by the way, this is what we are doing in SwiftUI Camp. Number four is kind of, it is in SwiftUI Camp, but it's not that relevant. And number four is teach to solidify your knowledge. Now, this is the most powerful that I found out. This is why I started the YouTube channel. Of course, I just wanted to share my knowledge with you guys, but I am not doing this only for you. I'm doing it also for myself because when I teach something, I also solidify that knowledge. Also, by teaching, when I start, I want to teach you something, I have to I have to have a bulleted list of what I want to have, just like I have it right over here. And that solidifies and clears the knowledge in my mind. Now, how do we do this in SwiftUI Camp? Well, you could, if you wanted to, and I highly encourage that, you could just share what you have been building on these active recalls and actionable repetitions along that week. So, when the new session comes, I highly recommend that you just come out and say, okay, this is what I did in 5 minutes or less. Just let me know what you've been building in a teaching manner, and that will solidify your knowledge like 100%. I assure you that this is why I love to teach, one of the reasons. And finally, we came to the bonus tip, and the bonus tip is that you need a mentor. Yes, this is how you want to hack your brain to learn to code better and smarter. Now, why is that? Well, the most important reason is that time is your best asset. So time is your most valuable asset, by the way. And if you are trying to learn all of this on your own, learning to code, well, actually, there's an abundance of information on the net, and that is kind of a blessing and also a curse because you don't really know where to start. You don't really know how to filter out the good stuff from the not that good stuff. And a mentor actually knows how you can take your current level from the next level. And basically that is what SwiftUI is. When you're going to join SwiftUI Camp, I'm going to ask you a few questions so I know how I can start from your level and then, just taking it from there. Also, a mentor can have a distilled knowledge of what you want to learn. It can guide you to the right path of the resources that you want to check out because I've already been there, I've been through all of that stuff. So you don't actually have to waste time on digging for, all of the scraps and all of the unnecessary stuff that you can avoid. And finally, a mentor can give you a structure of how you can learn. And this is what we do on a SwiftUI Camp. We start off by laying down the fundamentals, and then we talk about how you can manage SwiftUI data inside your apps. And then we go on creating the layout for our views. Why we do that, we connect that to Firebase authentication and Firestore, all of this in a very, very structured manner to come up with the end result of a clone in for Twitter in SwiftUI and Firebase, but along the way, you will learn advanced SwiftUI techniques, so you can take your SwiftUI game a notch up. Okay, so if you want to have a little bit of taste of what we are going to do in the very first hours of SwiftUI Camp, I highly recommend that you check out Firebase authentication in this video right over here.